Hello children, welcome to the English class with Ivy ma'am. Children, let's get ready with our Oxford revised edition of New Pathways course book. Let's start with the course book. Chapter 1, Tansen, the Magical Musician. Chapter 1, Tansen, the Magical Musician. Before starting with the chapter, let us look at the list of the characters. Let's see the list of characters in this story first. The first is Tansen. Tansen is the main character of the story. He was a well-known figure in Indian classical music. Okay? Number 2, Mukund Mishra. Mukund Mishra was Tansen's father. Number 3, Mohammad Ghaus. Mohammad Ghaus was a famous saint and a musician. Number 4, Haridas. Haridas was Tansen's teacher. Number 5, ruler of Gwalior. Now children, the ruler of Gwalior, his name is not mentioned in the story, so we will not name him. We will just call him as ruler of Gwalior. Number 6, King Ramachandra. King Ramachandra was the ruler of Rewa. So King Ramachandra was the ruler of Rewa. Number 7, Akbar. Akbar was the emperor of India. Number 8, courtiers. Number 9, Rupa. Rupa was a singer who sang the Megh Rag to save Tansen. So, how many characters did we come across? Tansen, Mukund Mishra, Mohammad Ghaus, Haridas, ruler of Gwalior, King Ramachandra, Akbar, courtiers, and Rupa. Can you see the picture of Tansen? This is Tansen. This is Haridas. Haridas was Tansen's teacher. And this, Emperor Akbar. Now, let's get started with the story. Almost exactly in the center of India is a town called Gwalior. In this town is the tomb of Tansen. Tomb is a monument which is made in memory of a dead person and it is erected over the burial place of a dead person. So if we are talking about Tansen's tomb, it means the monument which is made over Tansen's burial place. One of the greatest musicians that ever lived. Next to his beautifully carved stone tomb stands a little tamarind tree. It is believed that by eating a leaf of this tree and touching the tomb, a singer can improve his voice. Now children, exactly in the center of India, our country, there is a town called Gwalior. And in this town is the tomb of Tansen. Who's Tansen? Tansen was one of the greatest musicians that ever lived. He was a great musician. And next to his beautifully carved stone tomb, his tomb is beautifully carved with stone. And just beside that stands a little tamarind tree. Okay? Tamarind tree stands beside his tomb. And it is believed that by eating a leaf of this tree and touching the tomb, if a singer would eat the leaf and touch the tomb of Tansen, he could improve his voice. If this sounds like magic, the story of Tansen is equally magical. If you find this, you know, as a magic,
Okay, if this sounds to you like a magic, that eating a leaf of this tamarind tree and touching the tomb, a singer can improve his voice, then the story of Tansen is also equally magical. Even today, many famous musicians follow the style of music created by Tansen, known as the Gwalior Gharana. Now, what is the meaning of Gharana? Gharana is a style or school of classical music. Okay, children, remember, Gharana is a style or school of classical music. So, even today, many famous musicians, they follow the style of Tansen, of the music created by Tansen, and it is known as the Gwalior Gharana. About 400 years ago, in a village near Gwalior, lived a wealthy poet, Mukund Mishra, and his wife. They longed to have children of their own. On the suggestion of a friend, Mishra went to Gwalior to seek the blessings of the famous saint and musician Mohammad Ghose. Almost like magic, soon after receiving the blessings, a child was born. He was named Tansen. As Tansen grew up, his father engaged teachers to teach him to read and write. Tansen, however, was more interested in going to the nearby forest with his friends, where he would imitate bird and animal sounds. Now, children, about 400 years ago, in a village near Gwalior, lived a wealthy poet. Now, this poet was very wealthy. Wealthy means rich. His name was Mukund Mishra, and he used to stay with his wife. Now, they did not have children. This wealthy poet, this rich poet, Mukund Mishra and his wife, they were longing to have children of their own. They were not having their own child, and they were longing for a child. Now, on the suggestion of a friend, Mishra, he went to Gwalior to seek the blessings of a famous saint and musician, Mohammad Ghose. And it was just like a magic that soon after receiving the blessing, a child was born. Now, this child was named as Tansen. Who were the parents of Tansen? Mukund Mishra and his wife. So now, as Tansen, he grew up, his father engaged. Engaged means here it is appointed or hired. So his father appointed or hired teachers to teach him to read and write. Tansen was more interested in going to the nearby forest with his friends. He was not that much interested in reading and writing. He was more interested in going to the nearby forest with his friends, and there he would imitate means copy. There he would copy bird and animal sounds. Once a group of singers were passing through the forest. Tansen hid himself in some bushes and roared like a tiger. So lifelike was the sound that the singers became frightened. When the boy showed himself, the leader of the group praised his tiger-like roar. Encouraged, Tansen made more animal and bird sounds. The leader was greatly impressed by Tansen's performance. He was none other than the famous music teacher Haridas. Now, what happens, children, is once a group of singers were passing through the forest. When they were passing through the forest, Tansen hid himself in some bushes and he started roaring like a tiger. So lifelike was the sound that the singers became frightened.
That sound was so realistic that the singers became frightened. When the boy showed himself, the leader of the group praised his tiger-like roar. When he came in front of the singers, the leader of the group praised his tiger-like roar. He encouraged Tansen and made more animal and bird sounds. Tansen was so encouraged that he made more animal and bird sounds. The leader of those singers was greatly impressed by Tansen's performance. And who was the leader? The leader was none other than the famous music teacher Haridas. Haridas offered to take Tansen as his disciple. He has great musical talent, said Haridas to Tansen's father. Most reluctantly, Tansen's mother agreed to let her only child go away to Vrindavan to study under Haridas. Now what happened is, this famous teacher, music teacher Haridas, he offered to take Tansen and make him his disciple, his student. He was so impressed with him that he said that he has great musical talent, and most reluctantly, most unhappily, Tansen's mother finally managed to agree to let her only child, she had only one child, so by hard means she agreed to send her only child to Vrindavan to study under the music teacher Haridas. For almost 10 years, Tansen studied music from Haridas, starting with the basic musical notes Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Dha, Ni, Sa. He learned the basics of singing and playing the Tanpura. He learned about the different rags of Indian music and how each rag creates a different mood. A rag can make you so happy that you might want to dance, or it can make you so sad that it might bring tears to your eyes. Now children, for almost 10 years, Tansen studied music from his music teacher Haridas. He started from the basics. He started from the basic musical notes Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. He learned the basics of singing and playing the Tanpura as well. He learned different rags of Indian music, and each rag created a different mood. Okay, now a rag is said to make you so happy that you might want to dance, or it can make you so sad that it might bring tears to your eyes. Then one day there was a message from home that his father was very ill. Unhappy that you have become a musician, go and see Mohammad Ghaus, were his father's last words to him. Though very sad, Tansen decided to keep his promise to his father to go to Mohammad Ghaus and be trained by him. But in keeping with Indian tradition, he went to seek permission to learn under a new guru from his first guru, Haridas. Now, one day, there was a message from home that his father was very ill. So Tansen went back home, and when he went there, he met his father. His father told him that he was very happy that he has become a musician. His father then asked him to go and see Mohammad Ghaus, where his father's last words to him. His father's last words to him were that go and meet Mohammad Ghaus. Though very sad, Tansen decided to keep his promise to his father. Because he had made a promise to his father that he will go and meet Mohammad Ghaus and he'll be trained by him, Now, who was Mohammad Ghaus? He was a famous saint and musician. Now, keeping his words, he had to go and meet him. But in keeping with the Indian tradition, he first went to seek permission from his first guru. Who was the first guru? Haridas. You must obey your father's wishes, but you will always be welcome here. You are like a son to me, said Haridas, blessing his favorite disciple. Now, when Tansen went to Haridas to seek his permission, he told him that you must obey your father's wishes, but he also added that Tansen would always be welcome back to Haridas, and he also told him that he was like his son. Now, Haridas blessed his favorite disciple. Who was his favorite disciple, favorite student? Tansen. Tansen studied under Mohammad Ghaus for 3 years, developing his musical talent. During that time, Mohammad Ghaus introduced Tansen to the ruler of Gwalior. They became good friends, and Tansen would often visit the ruler's palace, where he would listen to other musicians. Now, Tansen studied under Mohammad Ghaus for 3 years. Now, developing or making his musical talent, he kept on learning from Mohammad Ghaus for 3 years. During that time, Mohammad Ghaus, his second teacher, introduced him to the ruler of Gwalior. Now, they became very good friends, and Tansen would often visit the ruler's palace. He would often go and visit the ruler's palace, the ruler of Gwalior's palace, where he would listen to the other musicians as well. One day, a messenger arrived from the court of Rewa near Gwalior. The messenger opened the scroll and read, King Ramachandra of Rewa would like you to be a musician at his court. Now, one day a messenger arrived from the court of Rewa. Now, Rewa is near Gwalior. When the messenger opened the scroll, what means scroll? Scroll means a long roll of paper which was used for writing in the olden days. So, he opened the scroll and started reading. King Ramachandra of Rewa would like you to be a musician at his court. Now, King Ramachandra, who was ruling Rewa, he was the ruler of Rewa, he wanted Tansen to be a musician at his court. This was a great honor and the first step in Tansen's rise to fame. King Ramachandra admired Tansen's singing. The Emperor Akbar once went on a visit to Rewa. King Ramachandra arranged for Tansen to entertain his royal guest. The emperor was greatly impressed by Tansen's music and soon after his return sent a message to Ramachandra requesting him to send Tansen to his court. Now, this was great honor and it was the first step of Tansen's rise to fame, gaining lot of fame, name, fame. Now, King Ramachandra used to admire Tansen's singing. He was really very, very happy with Tansen's singing. The Emperor Akbar once went on a visit to Rewa, and King Ramachandra arranged for Tansen to entertain his royal guest. Who was the royal guest? Emperor Akbar. Now, the emperor was greatly impressed. He was so highly impressed by Tansen's music that soon after his return, he sent a message to Ramachandra requesting him to send Tansen to his court. King Ramachandra did not want to part with Tansen, but he could not afford to displease the powerful Akbar. After all, Akbar was the emperor of India and Ramachandra was only the king of a small state in Akbar's empire. Now, children, King Ramachandra, he was not ready to part with Tansen, but he could not afford to displease the powerful Akbar, because Akbar was the emperor of India and Ramachandra was just the king of a small state in Akbar's empire.
India was ruled by Akbar and a small state was ruled by Ramachandra. So Ramachandra could not displease Emperor Akbar. So reluctantly, what means reluctantly? Reluctantly means not very willingly. Okay, here unhappily. So unhappily, King Ramachandra sent Tansen to Akbar as a royal gift. Akbar was so impressed by Tansen's music that he bestowed on him the highest honor of the land. Tansen was included among his Navratna, 9 jewels, the 9 most outstanding talents of the royal court. Now, what happened after this is, Akbar was so impressed by Tansen's music that he bestowed means gave something to somebody, especially to show respect. So he gave the highest honor of the land, which was including him among his Navratna. Navratna means the 9 jewels, the 9 most outstanding talents of the royal court. Besides performing in the court, Tansen would often sing alone for the emperor. At night, he sang rags that would soothe and help Akbar fall asleep. And in the morning, Tansen sang special rags that would gently awaken the emperor. There are many stories told about the power of Tansen's music. It is said that when Tansen sang, birds and animals would gather to hear him. Besides performing in the court, Tansen would also often sing alone for the emperor. At night, he would sing songs or rags that would soothe, that would make Akbar fall asleep. And in the morning, Tansen sang special rags that would gently wake him up. There are many stories, children, told about the power of Tansen's music. It is said that when Tansen sang, all the birds and animals would gather to hear him. Now, children, this much will be covered.
We have now come to the end of part 1 of chapter 1, Tansen the Magical Musician. We will continue the story in part 2. Keep looking out for the next video, part 2 of chapter 1, Tansen the Magical Musician. Till then, take care, stay safe, bye-bye, children.